Okay, everyone, this is Fast Lenny on the mic on the Rail TV. We got the second set of the Women's Grandmaster Finals. It's a race to seven. Kimberly Kirk with the first break. K2 playing Kim Jones. We are live from the Chinook Winds Casino Resort in Lincoln City, Oregon. 2015 Western BCA Nine Ball Championships. Kimberly Kirk defeated Kim Jones in the first set, forcing the second set. It is true double elimination format here at the Western BCA. Well, this is going to be a tough hit here on the two ball for Kim Jones. Both players, I'm sure. Kim looks the fresher. Kimberly Kirk looks the fresher of the two. She looks like she's a little bit more focused and maybe a bit more energy. Scratch there, and Kimberly Kirk's gonna have ball in hand. She got a decent bump there to be able to pocket the three ball, but now the six ball is tied up close to the nine. Good shot there from Kimberly Kirk. Well, that certainly helped out the cause, and All she has to do is play position from the 5 to 6. The 7 ball is close to the corner pocket. She looks like she's on a mission. Good shot. Now this 6 ball, she's probably going to follow it and go 2 rails out for the 7 ball. This 9 ball for the first game. Game 1 goes to Kimberly Kirk. K2. Looking to double dip Kim Jones. You are watching OnTheRailTV.com. This is the 18th annual 2015 Western BCA 9 Ball Championships. We're live from the Chinook Winds Casino Resort on the central Oregon coast in beautiful Lincoln City. We'd like to thank the Lincoln City Visitors Bureau and Bud Light, the official beer sponsor of this event. See if Kim Jones can get out here. Tough positional shot from the 2 to the 3. Thank you. Well, that miss is going to bring Kimberly Kirk to the table. She could have a good opportunity here to go up 2-0. Perfect position, it looks like. She's got the 9 in the corner. She can go up 2-0 over Kim Jones. K2 looking like she's on a mission in the zone. There we go, 2-0. K2 with the break up 2-0 over Kim Jones in this race to 7. Oh, she scratches on the break and ball in hand for Kim Jones. Kimberly Kirk breaks really well and she's made 2 balls on the break. 3 if you count the cue ball. Nice wide open table for Kim Jones and you would expect him to get out here. It is late though. We're approaching 11 p.m. Pacific time. Don't know what time these ladies woke up, but I know I'm feeling tired and I'm just sitting here. Oh, she's bumped to 6, but she's okay. She can pocket this 3 ball and just draw the cue ball back slightly and you know, the 6-7 is going to be tricky. Where the 7 ball is, it's not going to be easy. We are using the Cyclop ball set, and the lime green ball is the 6 ball. The light blue ball is the 7 ball. Don't know if that 7 goes on the side. If it doesn't, she'll have to cut it up in the corner. Well, no shot here on the 8 other than a kick. And that's what she's going to go for. She's probably going to kick this ball. 1 rail. Things are just not going Kim Jones' way here in this finals. Good effort, but Kimberly Kirk, she will be coming to the table with a easy out. 3-0, Kimberly Kirk. On the Rail TV would like to thank some of our sponsors. PlayTheGameClothing.com. Check them out. You can get 20 to 30% off at PlayTheGameClothing.com. World class builded apparel. They have a special deal where you can pick up a hoodie and get a free t-shirt with it. Not a bad idea. RemoveNames.com. If you want to get your name removed from any site that's online, you can do so. Volturi Q cases. Beautiful cases. You see a lot of pro players carrying them, along with having town break and jump tips on their cues. The Iceman, Mika Eminen, Rodney the Rocket Morris, Scott the Freezer Frost, they all got them. AZBilliards.com for all your billiard news. Appreciate all their support. Bad Boys Billiard Productions for all their hard work here. They do a great job. QB Custom Cues, they've been on board with us for a long time, and we appreciate all that they do, and they make some high-quality cues. You could have your ad here if you like. Just contact me, Fast Lenny, at On The Rail TV. Just go to ontherailtv.com and go to the contact, or you can contact me at LennyMarshall@live.com or ontherail@live.com. Really, Kirk just hitting balls. It's a player break. Kim Jones will be back shortly. Well, it looks like the players are back here, and we can resume this match. Kim Jones to break. Kimberly Kirk leading 3-0 in this race to 7. was a pretty impressive break. Four balls in the break, but I don't think she's got a shot on the one ball. Kim Jones looking like she's going to run this out. There we go, 3-1. Nice break. She's got a shot on the one ball. K2, Kimberly Kirk leading 3-1. Natural position to go down for the two off this one ball. She's missed the two ball, and Kim Jones, I don't think, has a shot here. Might have the edge of the two, but that's probably about it. I don't think she can see this directly. Might be wrong. Oh, she made it off the eight and got position on the four. Five balls kind of blocked a little bit by the seven.
Okay, so we will be taking.
So this is a little tricky.
Seniors second chance tournament, not tonight, but they will in the morning until noon, with tentative play to start at 2 p.m. for the men's seniors second chance. So that gives you time to get through your matches tonight, decide what you want to do.
Kim might try to play this nine ball, but I think playing safe would be the better shot. But where is the question? Oh, it's not good enough. She's left the look at the five to play safe off of. There's no real shot here. Other than a safety. Pretty good shot there. Kimberly Kirk says, take that. Kim Jones at the table. Don't know how much of the five she can see. Kimberly Kirk could fire the 5-9, but I think you're going to see her play safe. She could actually go thin off the edge of the 5 and maybe try to get the cue ball behind the 9 and the 7. Now she's looking at the combination. I bet this won't roll off at all. She's going to hit it with a little bit of pace, a little bit of hot sauce on it. I think I need to get Pace as a sponsor on the live stream. Well, she'd like to play a good shot there, the safety, but the cue ball's leaked out. Well, the good thing is the 7-9 is tied up. So, although Kim Jones might be able to make the 5 and the 6, the 7 ball does not have a pocket. Was a heck of a breakout. Could have worked out a little bit better for her, but she's trying to play safe here, and she's done a great job. That was a very nice shot. Kim Jones is telling K2, you might win this, you might double dip me, but you're gonna have to earn it. You're gonna have to do something right here, right now. Kimberly Kirk leading 3-1, but if she doesn't make a good hit here, it will be 3-2. She made a bad hit there, and it's going to be cue ball in hand for Kim Jones.
you have a an external hard drive, I could put all of them on there for you, and you could have them on your computer. I could transfer them all over. That makes life easier. Then I'm going to upload them. I talked with Mike Howerton of AZ Billiards, and they have an AZB TV channel on Vimeo. You might put them all on there, too, along with YouTube. That way, if there's any copyright stuff with music, Vimeo is a little bit easier.
Yeah.
So we're going to transfer even the old videos over there. They'll be on both. So they'll be able to access them in two different places. It's pretty good.
I mainly just need finals as soon as possible, really.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I uploaded the finals to the Chinook Winds Open, both of them, to YouTube today.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Which reminds me, when I get back, I gotta share the link with everybody so they know that it's online. If you have a hard drive, I can transfer whatever videos you want onto it from the computer as well. Yeah.
That's not a bad safety. Kim Jones is down one game in this race to 7. Lots of pool left in this match. Kimberly Kirk did defeat Kim Jones in the first set, forcing this second set. We are burning the midnight oil here at On the Rail TV. And so are these players. Look at this shot. That's going to work out nicely for her. Wow. I think Kim Jones does have the edge here. If she can, she'll try to thin the one, but it looks like the cue ball will go into the 3 or the 8. We shall see. Well, she'd like to play it that way. And we might see a billiard on the 9 here. Oh, she elected to go for it, and she's scratched. And that's going to potentially cost her this game. We'll see what Kim does with it. Table's pretty open. I don't know if the 8 goes past the 9. We're going to find out shortly.
conference tables, but it's 11 and 30.
I'm back. Hey, Paul. Welcome back.
Thanks, Len. So, what's the score here? What's happening?
Tied up at 3-3. This is
3-3.
The second 3-3.
Race yeah. to 7, you're
Race
saying,
to
right?
7, yeah.
Well, you know, this girl's had a history of some great accomplishments, so...
Yeah, Kimberly Kirk won the first set. And,
did she?
Yeah.
So, okay. Kimberly also has had some great accomplishments. She's just such a great, great person, that Kimberly. One of these days, I'm going to find one just like her. Hey, guys.
She's got an excellent break.
Yeah, and look at this. This is how about this for a nice way to start off?
I've seen her break the balls consistently very well, and she hits them solid.
Mm-hmm. Well, she's looking at it like she's not too happy, but really all she's got to do is clip that three ball, come out between the five and six, and just bounce into the center of those two diamonds there. And then she just stops the ball on the four. She's fine with the five because of where the six is. It's about really looking for paths rather than worrying about obstacles. Top pros look for paths. So right now she looks like she's going to really hit this ball hard for some reason. Just soft, real soft. That's an awful big stroke for a soft shot. It's an awful big stroke, just too much, no need. I'm surprised and disappointed there for poor Kimberly. I would have loved to have seen her just soft, roll that ball and mm-hmm. come off those two rails. And she didn't need to get real close. It's a 7-foot table.
Yeah, and I don't think she can make this.
I don't think she can see it.
She's looking at it as if it's possible.
I hope she
maybe
can.
Maybe a little swerve on
she's
it.
She's looking like she's going to make it. Let's see. Maybe she can make it. Oh, she got away with it, didn't she? Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. She's yeah. playing with fire. Is Even if she can't see
is.
This, I think the five's off the rail a little bit so she can hit the rail first and roll that in. The thing about this is that the six ball is in such a fabulous position
mm-hmm.
From where the five is. So you make the five, you can get on the six really, really good because the seven's way out there where, in a position where you can get to the center of the table, you can get a shot at it. Just roll it in. Don't do much with it. Don't go too hard. Oh, she hit the six first, didn't she? Yeah, she did.
Yeah, cue ball in hand for Kim Jones.
Oh, well, that's unfortunate. So really right now, Kim's got a really good, great opportunity to get out. Now the key is gear is going to be getting on the seven to get the angle to get on the eight. So the best way to play this is to get on the seven in such a way that you're going not towards the nine, but you're going towards the side rail off of it. Well, I don't know why she did that. That's interesting. I thought she played in the side. Ball in hand, not move the cue ball very far, right? Mm-hmm. But I'm not saying it's wrong, I'm just saying it was a surprise to me, because now it's going to be harder for her. So now she's going towards the nine instead of going towards the rail to get on the eight. It's not that it's not possible, it's just mm-hmm. It's just adding a lot more drama.
Oh, look at this.
Yeah, well, again, a lot more drama. That could just as easily have gone up and snookered her behind the nine ball.
Or even scratched in that corner. She was very close. And very close.
It's all because of how she shot the first ball, I thought. And this is too hard again.
And she's overhitting everything. She's just...
Yeah, she sure is. And this is not going to be easy, frozen to the back rail here. So, she's a good potter, so she can get herself out of trouble. But she's putting herself in trouble every shot. And again, very close too, right? So...
that was an impressive out. Yeah, it is.
Well, I don't know about impressive. Yeah. It's exciting. But it was all about she had to keep on putting herself in bad positions and getting out of it.
Well, just her shot making, she just looked like she was freewheeling, like they're just practicing, just hitting the balls.
Yeah.
Unbelievable, you know?
Well, I think that's a level below her. I don't think that's really...
Yeah, it could be the midnight oil burning.
Thanks, Cosmo. I appreciate the plug for me. And Sinchan, who is that?
That's
hello, by the way, as well. And Cosmo, again, thanks for the plug. Dramatic is right, that's for sure. That was definitely dramatic. But fun to watch. Hey, it's a lot more fun watching that stuff than tap, 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 tap.
I agree.
But if you're on the playing part, if you're the one playing out there, I don't think that's the way you really want to play.
No, I agree.
Playing tournaments.
Well, players are on a little break. We've had a few of them.
Hey, Bev Ashton, are you still listening in here? I know you were watching earlier and you made some comments. I appreciate that. Are you show me that you love me? This is wonderful, huh? Kimberly wins the first match. We're going to a hill again. This is twice now that the Grandmasters with Stan and Jim, they went two sets. Very exciting.
Yeah, it's
going to an exciting two set match here too. It's awesome.
No, I was just letting Paul talk, Cindy. I didn't want to interrupt him. I recognize your username now after today. It's an interesting username. What is it? Sinchan 76.
Somebody born in 1976, maybe?
Not sure. So you got any lessons lined up here at the event?
I had a couple of people come up to me and ask me for lessons, but we haven't really gotten together for those. And then a number of people that I've given analysis to that have been really interested in doing the online stuff. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
Again, I'm here for exposure. I just want people to know about the app and that what I do online. And it's great always to, you know, meet a whole bunch of new pool players.
And there's a lot of them here.
There sure are. It's great.
Teams would be coming in. This place is going to be packed. This is nothing.
Chan is Japanese for cute. Well, kind of. Nihongo dekimasu. Takara. So, Chan wa, like, more like close to, you know, for your brother, for your sister, actually, or for your... cousin maybe, or your good friend, your daughter. Most of the time, chan would be for a female, and they go kun for a male, like Naoki kun or Hiro kun, that kind of thing. You have the app? Oh, awesome! Great. Okay, we spoke a few times this week and haven't been introduced. 私の名前はポールです。Takara is my daughter's middle name. Okay, Takara. Sounds Japanese to me. Takara.
Well, it looks like Kim Jones is back. She's going to be breaking the balls, leading 4-3.
Uh-huh, and the two balls in the back there in this one, so I think that's where it's supposed to be. My app is called the Pocket Billiards Coach, and it's on iPhone and iPad, and it's a free download. And if after you've read a little bit, you decide that you'd like to hear me, to hear the voice recordings and watch the videos, it's $2.99 for all the features. But it's free to download on the App Store, iPhone and iPad only. It's a coaching app, so it's all about helping you develop your game from wherever you are to where you want to be.
Second chance men's 80 singles, second chance women's 80 singles. Those records are now
all. How are you guys liking the stream, by the way? Is it clear to you? Is it clear?
Check your bracket for when you play tomorrow. Once again, second chance men's 80 singles.
Your ex-husband's calling you. Okay. Well, I call my daughter Sakura. I call her Sakura-chan, of course. And she doesn't call me Daddy-chan. Just Daddy.
Well, this is going to be tricky going from the one to the two. She's going to go Ralph first and slide up. Because I don't think.
Oh, great. You have the full version of the app on your iPad? Yeah, I know on the iPad it looks a little bit small. All the icons look a little smaller, don't they? So, because it was designed for an iPhone instead of. And it's very clear. The streaming's very clear. Great. Good. I'm happy to hear that. It's a great shot. That's good speed, too. You don't really want to overhit that ball, you know, so it's a spin that you want to use to for the energy.
She did well. Spin.
She did very well there. It's a great, great, great.
Now, do you like shot. Coming over to shoot this three in the corner, or do you like to try to draw this ball and play to the center for the three in the side?
Okay, that's good to know. So, Lenny, they say your stream is the best quality, best... best video, best audio for streams. Awesome. Well, I want to hear that too. I want to know that. My first experience with you.
Yeah, it's nice to have you in the booth, and you do some great commentary. Everybody seems to enjoy it.
That's great. Well, I'm not too drunk yet. No, I'm just joking. Oops. No fighting now.
Yeah, in the chat room. Little chat room fight,
chat
huh?
Room.
Well, that's a looks like a good shot if it slows down.
Well,
I think she did okay.
I think she did it the harder.
Yeah.
One, two, and then behind the nine.
Uh-huh.
And
yeah.
Then it would have been so much more difficult. This is quite easy to hit.
And she's going to jump it. It's
oh,
only a half
you.
Ball jump, too.
Hey,
so.
We're a good team, they're saying. How's that?
Nice. Good.
All right. Oops, what is she doing? She's jumping it, okay.
Yeah.
Let's see how she jumps. It looks like she jumps good. And see how she's looking over the ball. That's good. You know, I'll tell you what, it pays to hit it. I'll tell you, whenever you're snookered, it pays to hit it. Things can happen.
Yeah, you might make the ball or get safe as Kim Jones just did.
Guys. Well, Kimberly's definitely got her game face on here, that's for sure. I think she's ready to not make any more mistakes. That's what it looks like to me. Very serious, very definite, seeing the lines. Yeah. Oops. Not quite. I don't think the plan was that bad. Just maybe a little bit too thin.
Hey, you would expect...
Kim's got a little bit of a difficult thing here. It's tough to miss the six ball, especially if she's jacked over the five. Yeah. She spin it with a lot of left English, she could miss it. Yeah, there you go.
She did a good job.
Very good. Very good. That's about perfect.
This might even be more difficult, right? You just come back and forth and get to the other side. She's elevated over the eight. This is not easy.
No, but she's looks like
this. Look at this
she
shot.
She likes that.
Very nice. She struck that well.
It took me years, you know, to finally become very good at jacked over the balls, and to do that, I decided I'm just hitting every single one of them center ball, you know, along the vertical line. No more English on jacked up balls, and it made my ability to make jacked up over balls about 85%.
No, yeah. If you try 50%. To put English on it like a regular shot, it's just
yeah. I used to do that. I, you know,
next thing you know, you start swerving the ball because you're elevated, right?
Yeah, my ego got in my way. You know. But it's amazing, just by changing it to center ball, 85% or more, you know, making the ball. So
I practice jacked up shots quite often, just because it comes up a lot in one pocket.
So you're a one pocket player, right?
I love one pocket.
Awesome.
I think it's
wow.
a great game.
The greatest one pocket match I've ever seen was, surprisingly, was like just about a year and a half ago, I guess. Oh, my God, that's just not the way to do that. You don't go into the nine ball. Because, you know, Murphy's Law happens.
Yeah.
Give yourself a chance to go have something go wrong, it will.
I agree.
Alex Pagelian versus Scott Frost in Hard Time Billiards in L.A. 20,000. 10 ahead for 20,000. 8 ahead, I think it was.
Yeah.
Oh, awesome. What a great match.
Well, they just played again in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And
at the Q Club?
It was at a new pool room called Good Times. They played again, and this time it wasn't a one day deal. It went on for I think 4 or 5 days. The headset. It was, Scott was playing a lot better than he did the first time.
Well, he didn't play that bad the first time. It's not about Scott. Scott didn't screw up. Alex was just playing awesome.
Scott was definitely not playing 100% the way he played the second time. He made Alex really earn it. I mean, he played.
Did Alex still win?
Alex still won, yeah. But he made him grind it out 5 days.
That's just wonderful. It's a wonderful game. It's, you know, one pocket is the pool game of snooker. Mm-hmm. Like it's or chess for sure. You know.
Wow. She just breaks the ball so good.
She does.
But Alex is the best all-around player alive right now, I feel.
It's amazing.
He's a fantastic player.
I mean, the stories I could tell you about Alex, you know, of course I know Alex really well, right? We played so much together against each other and with each other. But Alex, I believe, is the most talented individual I've ever met in my life, bar none from anything that I've ever seen. And you just have no idea. I mean, the impersonations that he can do. I had him with me in a couple of trick shot shows where I acted like I hypnotized him, and then I had him do Jose Parrica. And then when he acted like Jose, the crowd were rolling in the aisles, just going crazy.
Nice.
And then I had him do Buddy Hall, and you think it was Buddy Hall. And he's like half a Buddy Hall. It was just amazing, just so talented.
I like how he can jump from the floor flat-footed up on top of a pool table.
Exactly. Well, he can do that. He can jump the length of the pool table without moving, just one jump, a crouch jump, and he can jump up and hit, the ceiling, and pretty high ceilings. Not this one, of course, but it's just unbelievably talented. He learns so quick. It's amazing. Okay, whoa. Don't want to get over top that six ball there. That's really good. Now, there's options, like lots of options of what she can do here with this five ball to get to the six, to get to the seven. But she's really got to make sure she understands, you know, the different varieties. And so she wants to get on that six ball so she can get to the seven, even if the shot on the six is not as easy as she can get from a different position. Mm-hmm. It's definitely about getting on the seven ball here. So the angle she's got to get, that's fine. So yeah. Sometimes you get a little bit wider like that, you know. But she would have been better with more angle here to get to the seven, because drawing this ball, you can draw into the side pocket. You can spin this ball around as well. That's probably what I would do. Spin around the table instead of drawing backwards. See, because now drawing backwards, if she doesn't go far enough, she's got this difficult shot on it. Whereas spinning around the table, I'm not sure she saw that option, because she got down and looked at it real quick, what she's going to do, and that's it. And that's one of the things that really top pros do, is they really see the other options and make sure they choose the right one. I just don't think that she saw the other option, spinning, you know, 3-4 rails around.
It looks like she's going for the cut here.
Yeah, and that was just a little bit too quick. She might get lucky. No, she's not gonna. You know, when you're gonna shoot, like, she missed that by almost a diamond, right? So you really got to make sure. If you're not gonna, if you're not sure you're gonna put this into the hole, play it safety.
I agree.
We have to change our mind, you know, in order to be able to make sure we make a good choice that we're gonna win.
And this match is pretty tight, so every little game counting.
So someone's asked me here if I actually hypnotized Alex. We didn't actually hypnotize him. It was a show, so I made it look like I hypnotized him. He acted. It was all, you know, an act, but it was cool. When we did this in Japan, people thought I actually hypnotized him. They came up to me later going, "How you hypnotize him? Oh, that was quite." So no, I don't have a skill of hypnotizing. It's not one of my skills. Hypnotizing people.
Well, maybe you could learn it.
Maybe I can learn how. I'm not sure I need to. But I'm still working on, you know, getting to speak Japanese fluently. I study that every day. No, I don't hypnotize as a coach either.
Well, Kim Jones up 5-4 here and breaking.
Wow, and breaking.
Scratches.
Well, that's a mortal sin right there. There's no need for that. You know, rather hit him softer and not scratch than hit him hard and scratch. Scratching is the worst thing you can do on the break. Of course, I'm not telling anybody that doesn't know that, but there is no question.
Yeah, ball in hand here, open table.
Yep. But the 2-3 is tough. The 1-2-3 is not easy. There's a lot of things that can go wrong here. Do you make the 1 and go past the 4 and 3 to get the 2 in the side to get to the 3? The shooting it in the corner, it just seems to be pretty tough, unless you get straight in on it and then draw it back past the 8 a little bit. So (laughs) I don't know how to say radiation in Japanese. No, sorry. Probably radiation. No, I don't know. I don't know how to say radiation in Japanese, but I can find out right now. Just a sec.
How do you say Godzilla?
Godzilla. 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 Let's see how do you say radiation. I've got a dictionary right here. Okay, here we go. I'm going to get rid of this one and go radiation. Okay, it's translating for me. Okay, I'm going to have the speakerphone go on. Here we go. It's not working. Huh.
Well, it looks like Kimberly Kirk has got a chance here to run out and tie it up 5-5.
She does, and that's not bad. Getting on the side pocket, positioning for the side pocket was really, really the best way to go. They don't actually have any L's in the Japanese language, but radiation. So they go radiashione, radiashion. No, I don't think so. Could be though, but I can't find it here. I just got Chinese symbols on it, and I can't. It won't tell me here. What in the world? Isn't working.
Your question about the operating systems, which the stream works better on, Chrome, Firefox, Safari, I'm not quite sure. I use Google Chrome, but really, if you have a solid internet connection, watching the live stream is usually not a problem. You know, regardless of what browser you use, but I like Chrome, that's what I prefer. I was a longtime Firefox user. And switched over in the past year or so.
I can tell you how to say Paul in Japanese. Poru. And maybe cheesecake is chizukeku. I thought it would be chizukeki, but it might be chizukeku.
No, Kimberly Kirk looking to tie it up 5-5. It's really all in her hands right here. This is pretty easy out.
It should have no problem on this one. She should play that 8 ball in the side pocket. Should be no problem getting good position on it. Oh no, she didn't have any English on that. That's just brutal. She needed some left English on that ball, just a little bit. That's all she needed.
I think that's just the
nerves.
Time of night, nerves. You know? I think maybe a little fatigue and just didn't really...
Nerves.
Yeah, just...
She doesn't look very tired to me. Seeing the finish line. It's amazing how that can tighten up your hand and get you doing something you shouldn't have done.
It's going to be 6-4.
Silly girl, that's right. Wow, what a difference. 5-5 to 6-4. Huge. Who won the It's 10 right now. Who won the lag or the toss?
I think it might be Kimberly's break, they're saying. I don't know who won the toss. Yeah, well, Kimberly's going to be breaking the balls. Down 6-4 in a race to 7.
I don't understand why they don't put the 2 ball in the back.
Don't know if it's a standard rule or not. I know a couple times I've seen it done. I know, you know, maybe it's...
If you're racking for yourself, it's the most perfect rule. Put the 2 ball in the back. Okay, thank you. So the translation for radiation is Ho Sha Sen. So the reason that I pronounced the Ho very long is with that little thing on the top of the O means you pronounce O twice. So Ho Sha Sen. Wow, it's really it's not even quarter full here now to this time of the night.
It starts to clear out.
She's jumping this ball. Now, the key here is to know what to do with the jump, okay? So she could jump and make this ball, or she could jump and hit it thinner, hit it harder. What is she going to do? I would probably just jump and bank this ball. Jump bank.
Might ended up hooked here. The five's in front of the three. It's going to be...
She can kick that ball in after. She's using English on this in the jump. That's going to squirt way over to the right. Oh, she's not jumping then. That's a good shot. Except that she's going to be snookered by the 5 ball anyway, so it's going to be a kick the 3 ball anyhow. So now these are the kind of shots that you really want to, you know, you really want to practice and get good at, because see how far the ball is off the rail. You know, what's going to be best? Obviously, not hitting it on the right-hand side of the three, hitting it on the left side of the three, right?
Yeah.
So you gotta try and figure out how to hit that ball full on, and then aim more to the right of that, so that the ball, your cue ball, doesn't hit it full on. And then how far right do you hit? Using spin, the top pros are going to be using left English on this ball, so they can...
Now watch the scratch here.
If you use no English there.
Yeah.
But she got a hit. Pays to hit it. Okay, so we have a question for me here about low deflection shafts. Someone's saying, Mr. Putzi, do you have any thoughts on low deflection shafts? I'm a new player playing with maple shaft. Variations of LD, low deflection shafts, in the market have kept me away from them. Well, I'm a big believer in low deflection shafts, absolutely. You know, I personally have won 2 Canadian championship titles with normal shafts, but I'll never go back to a normal shaft, ever. Definitely low deflection shafts. I personally play with a Kevin DeRue low deflection shaft, but everything that I've tried out there, I can tell you that the 314 Predator, the original low deflection shaft, is still a very, very good shaft, and I highly recommend it. There are a couple that I don't want to say anything negative about any other shaft. So what I can just tell you is what I'd suggest you go after, and that is the 314 Predator shaft or the DeRue. Contact Kevin DeRue at kevinderuecues.com. Or kevindeRue.com. I think he makes the greatest low deflection shaft there is. But the 314 Predator is still very, very good. A lot of that has to do with what kind of tip you put on it as well, though. That's a good shot. That's a good angle on that ball. She's fine here. A little bit of inside English. Just make the ball and get in between the 6 and the 9 and just float out there close to the spot. Whoa, not enough English in that ball. She gave herself a chance for something to go wrong, and it just did. You've got to miss that 9 ball. You can't hit it. Either go on the one side or the other, but don't hit that 9 ball. Don't hit balls.
Now, this is a tough situation to be in right here. This is not easy at all.
And a lot of things, by the way, as far as shafts go, is like how tall you are, how long the how tall the cue should be. That's a very big part of what you should be considering when you're looking for a cue. The shaft is far more important than the butt, absolutely. And a low deflection shaft, I think, is a must.
What does she do here? This is going to be tough.
Yeah, this is tough. I think she should be drawing just what she's doing. Just draw the ball, just draw the cue ball into the side rail a little bit here, and knock the cue ball, the 6 ball to the back rail between the 7 and the 8, and just leave the cue ball on the side rail. So it's about speed control here. I don't think she needs a rest. I mean, she's right-handed. What is she doing there? Why don't she just? This is very well done. It's excellent. Perfecto.
That was a great shot. I think you're going to see Kim jump here. Yeah, she's grabbed the short cue. I can't blame her either. This has potential. You know.
It does. It's close enough to the eight ball that there's so many ways for this to go right for you. And that's not, it's not Kimberly's fault. Kimberly did a great job here, but Kim could end up making this ball and getting a shot after. Its chances are very good. It's more than 70%, 80% that she makes the ball. Nice shot, Kim.
Well, these 3 balls, and Kim's going to take it down. She will be the champion of the Women's Grand Masters.
And it looks like she's going to do that right now. I would certainly bet that she's out here. Just bring the cue ball up to the center of the table. It's so easy to do that. Center of the table. That's good. Stun off the rail. Come back to where the 7 ball is right now. Just stun off the rail. Come right back to where the 7 ball is right now. Okay, a little English and get a little bit closer. That's a little bit more dangerous, but that'll work. In fact, it's going to be perfect.
This is a well-earned victory, done. You know? Well-earned victory. She was down 3 to 2.
Well done. Worth the watch. Kim is an aggressive player, very good. Actually, so is Kimberly, but Kimberly just didn't seem to be as positive. Things were going against her a little bit, and she kind of handled
it. Kimberly was up 3-0 on the set, so, yeah. It's a good comeback. Basically, Kim Jones won 7 games to Kimberly's 1 to win the set. 7-4, second set.
All right. Well, that was fun. We'll do this some more.
Yeah, thanks for jumping in. And right, appreciate man. It.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to get some sleep. Thanks,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, good idea. Me too.
Awesome.
Thanks, man.
Yep, no problem. Thank you, Paul.